Well, hey everyone, this is Shirish and welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm back with another one of the amazing US universities, University of Southern California. USC is home to the School of Cinematic Arts that is almost always ranked as the top film school across the world. And not only the film school, most of its academic departments are top class and worth pursuing your degree. Let's look at the very famous and very versatile University of Southern California. Hi, I'm Shirish Gupta, and I empower people to hack their success, rise above the challenges, and confidently create an extraordinary life they deserve. University of Southern California is a private institution that was founded in 1880. The University of Southern California's central campus, referred to as the University Park Campus, is located in the Los Angeles Downtown Arts and Education Corridor. Yes, it's Los Angeles, home to Hollywood. USC's University Park campus has an unmistakably upscale vibe and offers a mix of traditional ivy-covered and modern structures arranged around fountains and reflecting pools, well shaded from the Southern California sun. Sitting on 226 park-like acres, just minutes from downtown Los Angeles, USC students have artistic brilliance and ambitious drive. USC is a veritable urban oasis. Some nearby areas are pretty rough, but thanks to USC's police department, most students say they never felt unsafe. Though Los Angeles is hardly a college town in the traditional sense, it does allow you to experience a wide variety of cultures and opportunities. Whether you are looking for an internship at a law firm or a movie studio, or you want to learn to surf, or you're eager to check out a new band before they get signed to the major label, LA delivers. Famous Venice Beach is just a few miles from USC campus. The most popular majors at USC include business, social studies, visual and performing arts, engineering, communications, and the very famous cinematic arts. Although I'm not a big fan of judging a university solely on the basis of the ranking, still USC is one of the top 10% universities in the world according to US News, QS News, and other major ranking services. Alright, let's now move on to our next section, the right fit, starting with academic fit. The academic climate is very challenging. New students often have to adjust because either they are not the best in their class anymore or they have to work harder to be the best. USC's core curriculum requires 9 courses, 6 general education, 2 intensive writing, and 1 diversity. Together, they give students the tool to think critically, communicate clearly, and locate themselves in history. USC offers students the chance to pursue degrees not only in the College of Letters, Arts, and Sciences, but also at any of its 20 professional schools and colleges of arts. In fact, USC strongly encourages students to pursue double majors or a combination of majors and minors in unrelated academic fields. This means business majors may minor in bioethics or computers. International relations majors may double major in urban planning or international urban development. And art history majors may study cinematic arts and television and music industry or business too. 59% of undergrad classes enroll fewer than 20 students, but the quality of teaching varies, especially in some introductory courses for freshmen, which can be huge, but overall the professors are truly amazing. USC offers various scholar programs and study abroad opportunities to students. USC students are a healthy mix of artistic brilliance and the ambitious drive. So I will rate USC with 4 stars on the academic quality and difficulty level, where 5 is the highest level. Well, after academic fit, let's move to our social fit. USC is a university on the move. Students here enjoy solid academics, a thriving social scene, and enough sunshine to craft a perfect tan. Well, they are drawing an academically competitive and involved student body. Pack your sunscreen, flip-flops, and some assertiveness, and you'll fit right in. The number of graduate students exceeds the number of undergrads at USC. It houses about 49,500 students with 21,000 undergrads and about 28,500 PG and PhD. USC has a whopping almost 25% international students, which is surely very diverse. USC prides itself on providing a healthy mix of artistic brilliance and ambitious drive to its students. For housing, 30% of USC undergrads live on campus. All freshmen are housed in residential colleges, which are led by faculty masters in residence and serve as hub for social life. Halls are co-ed, and New One North is definitely the social dorm that everyone in surrounding resident halls wish they lived in. Since swimming pools, tennis courts, carpeting, microwaves, refrigerators, and air conditioner are just some of the luxuries to be found in USC dorms, not to mention the brand new USC Village, it's no wonder more upperclassmen would like to stay on campus. But because there isn't enough space for everyone, students typically move after their first year to fraternity and sorority houses or apartments, which are just a short walk away from the campus. USC provides a variety of dining options on campus. grab-and-go snacks and coffee shops to meals at various full-service restaurants. Kosher, vegetarian, and vegan options are also. Most university housing plans for students do not require you to purchase a meal plan, but you can elect to do so if you wish. Dining halls offer plenty of options, including an international buffet in the Parkside complex. For clubs and activities, students can participate in more than 1,000 on-campus organizations. Yes, pretty huge. Ranging from religious groups to club sports, on-campus division sports are pretty much the biggest thing going. Trojan Athletics, which compete in Pac-12 conference, have won more than 125 team national championships in dozens of men's and women's sports, from baseball to water polo. USC offers a perfect balance between its academics and social activities. I would like to give it 4 stars out of 5 on the quality of life at USC. Well, now let's look at the financial fit. USC falls in an expensive school. You can expect up to $50,000 to $65,000 in annual tuition. Housing and dining may fall above $17,000 to $20,000 range. As far as financial aid is concerned, hundreds of merit scholarships averaging about $20,000 are awarded each year to American students, and as more than 340 athletics. USC also meets 100% of accepted students' demonstrated financial need and is need-blind in its admission. But for international students, it's not too general. You can get some scholarships for master's program, but it's extremely difficult to get scholarships for undergraduate programs. Very, very complicated. So I would rate it 2 stars on financial fit. Well, after exploring the fit, let's move to our most curious section on how to get admission into USC. USC is one of the most popular schools in the world. If you talk about acceptance rate, last year it was about 10 to 12%. Surely a better acceptance rate than most of the other Ivy Leagues, but still it is highly competitive. I would say USC is just a step below Ivy Leagues in terms of rankings, but it offers almost similar and in some cases even better education and resources like the famous Film School or Marshall School of Management, or even Viterbi School of Engineering. Like many highly selective universities, USC conducts a comprehensive, holistic review of applications to consider academic and personal category. USC reviews applicants' performance in school, the rigor of the program, writing skills, and test scores. USC also considers personal qualities as revealed in community involvement, leadership, and achievement. So it's comprehensive overall. For undergrad admissions, average SAT score ranges between 1400 to about 1550. And for master's, average GRE ranges between 315 to 330. And GMAT average score is about 700. Now let's talk about my admission advice to get into USC. The ideas I'm going to share now are not available anywhere and comes from my decade-long experience working with students for career and college. USC looks for students with high GPA and test scores. So make sure to work in your high school or in your college to boost your GPA as much. Maintain the top 10% of your class and you should be good too. Also make sure to have high SAT or GRE or GMAT scores for your admission, as USC looks carefully into that as well. Another thing USC looks for is your performance in school or college along with the rigor of your program. The rigor of your program means how have you challenged yourself academically? Did you choose easy subjects or have you pushed yourself to take more rigorous course? For instance, in high school, did you take physical education instead of mathematics? If so, then you have not pushed yourself academically. Similarly, in case of PG students, have you taken easy electives just to score higher grades, or have you tried to push the boundaries by taking difficult or higher level courses? Make sure to showcase how you have challenged yourself academically. Super important. USC looks into your story as well. So make sure to craft good essays for admission. I specifically want to give you this advice that I give to all my students in my Ivy cohort program is not to make your essays sound like a resume. Your essays should communicate your story, and that's one of the most important aspects to get into USC, or in fact, any college for that matter. Your story matters. USC acknowledges its students for personal growth and specifically for venturing outside their comfort zone. So make sure to talk about personal growth and venturing outside of your comfort zone in your application. If you haven't done so, try to do something outside of your comfort zone, and this could be participating in debates or public speaking, when you know you're not really good at it. Doing so will ensure you're learning while stepping outside of your comfort zone. Another way USC looks at applicants' personal quality is through community involvement, leadership, and achievement. Ensure to give USC enough information about your leadership roles and community involvement along with your achievements over high school or college. USC often regards its students who get involved by participating in student organizations and connecting with others. So make sure to do that in your high school or college. And talk about your involvement in your application, essays, or maybe through activity. For admission to postgraduate, in addition to all these points, make sure to have subject level knowledge for your academic major. Having research interest will surely be an additional plus for USC. Lastly, since a lot of students look for the cinematic school, and if you are one of them, make sure to create a diverse portfolio for admission. Well, this could be photographs, video films, designs, etc. Having a good portfolio is the absolute key in getting selected at USC Cinematic School and other non-academic majors where portfolio is required. As for deadlines, for admission to USC, there are two deadlines for undergrad programs, and the application goes through Common App. The first one is the scholarship deadline, which is about December 1st, and the other one is regular about mid of January. For all postgraduate courses, they have individual department deadlines with either one or two deadlines from November to January. In the end, to conclude, if you're hardworking, can handle intense pressure, fun-loving, love a lot of activities, amazing at time management, USC is the place for you. So that's it for today. I hope you have liked this video. Make sure to support my work by liking and sharing this video and also subscribe to my channel and hit that bell icon. Also, a very important thing, if you want to get admission to your dream college, you can check out my course on college. It's the most comprehensive course on the planet, teaching you tons of strategies for university shortlisting, building, essay writing, college interviews, and everything else that will make sure you get into the school of your dreams. Thank you once again. I'll be back with another amazing video for you. Till then, this is Shirish signing off. Take care and have a good day.